among many other things which I will not elaborate on, are among the major differences that we have in our belief in God. This is why the whole religion or the way of life of Islam is based on the foundation that our belief in Allah is that He is absolute in every way, shape, or form. He is self-sufficient. He is independent, and everything is depending on Him. Allah is independent of everyone, and all of the creation depend on Allah. He is absolute, and He has none equal to Him. This is the only true definition of God. Because we cannot define God, God must define Himself to us. God is the one who defines. We don't know. وَلَا يُحِيطُونَ بِشَيْءٍ مِنْ عِلْمِهِ إِلَّا بِمَا شَاءَ. Allah says in the Quran, Ayat al-Kursi, and they do not encompass any of His knowledge, except with what He wills. We have no knowledge of God, except what God has allowed us to know. So we cannot fabricate or attribute to God something that contradicts with His majesty, with His ultimate power, with His independence. Moving on, after believing in Allah and the variation that we have, we hold the position that Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. We go to the belief in angels. The angels in Islam are defined as being لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. They do not disobey Allah regarding any command from Him. And they do everything that they are commanded. And Allah says on another occasion, يَخَافُونَ رَبَّهُمْ مِنْ فَوْقِهِمْ. They are afraid of their Lord who is above them. This particular understanding of the angels teaches us that the angels, unlike the human beings, do not have the free will. The human beings have the free will to obey or disobey. فَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيُؤْمِنْ وَمَنْ شَاءَ فَلْيَكْفُرْ. So whosoever wishes to believe, let him do so. And whosoever wishes to disbelieve, then he has the right to do so. Of course, he will be held accountable on the Day of Judgment for that choice. But at the moment, that free will is there. The angels do not have that. That's what we find in Islam, that the angels are consistently obedient worshippers of Allah. Never disobey Him. When we go to the Christian understanding or perspective, we will find that the angels are divided into two. We have the good angels and the bad angels. And the biggest example that is common to us is Lucifer, which is Satan. One of his names is Lucifer, and he has been given this name because he is supposedly the fallen angel who disobeyed God, thus was kicked out of heavens. So he became a disobedient angel. And there's actually a sculpture of him, an idol of him, which shows him going like this with wings, and he's in the form of a human being with a snake wrapped around him, and supposedly, you know, he was kicked out of heaven, something along these lines. If you read the Bible, there are biblical texts which are too long to mention that indicate that this was the case. So there the angels are divided into two, good angel and a bad angel. So although we share the title with the Christians and our belief in angels, obviously there's a major distinction between both. So what is Satan then? Who is Satan? In Islam, we know that he's a jinni. Jinn. Jinn is a creation of Allah made out of a smokeless flame. Flame of fire, smokeless. It's another creation of Allah who are also responsible for being followers of the truth and who will also be held accountable on the Day of Judgment. Iblis, Satan, was among the jinn. Allah says, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ فَفَسَقَ عَنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّهِ. And if, when your Lord told the angels, prostrate to Adam, so they prostrated, except Iblis, Satan, then Allah gave us his definition. كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. He was among the jinn. فَفَسَقَ عَنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّهِ. So he disobeyed the commandment of his Lord. So in Islam then, Satan was never an angel who disobeyed and thus was kicked out. Rather, he's among the jinn, and all the devils are among the jinn. There are devils among the humans, and there are devils among the jinn. So the major distinction then is that angels in Islam do not disobey Allah. They do what is commanded. They fear their Lord. They have been given assignments and tasks to carry out in this world. This is part of their duty. And they never disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Whereas in Christianity, just to summarize again, an angel may obey God, he may disobey, he may do what is commanded, he may not, he may be a source of evil versus being a source of goodness. And this is a major distinction in the definition of both, although the heading of the angels is the same. Moving on to our belief in the divinely revealed books, Al-Kutub, which is a plural of Kitab, which is a book. Now, the technical legal definition of a scripture, if you want to be technical, is that which has been revealed by God and preserved. And this is really the between quotations here. And preserved. So if you want to be really accurate, the scriptures that are available today, besides the Quran, may not really be scriptures in the ultimate sense. The current ones we have. The followers who had a prophet among them, who had received a revelation, which was a scripture from God, they are called Ahlul Kitab, the people of the scriptures. Although today, the scripture which was given to the messenger may not be available anymore. And what is intended by that is the fact that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet, taught us his creation. نَزَّلَ عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ بِالْحَقِّ مُصَدِّقًا لِمَا بَيْنَ يَدَيْهِ وَنَزَّلَ التَّوْرَاةَ وَالْإِنْجِيلِ Allah says, He has sent down upon you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the book confirming that which came before it. And He has revealed the Torah and the Gospel. So the Quran and the Torah and the Gospel and the Psalms of David, when Allah says, وَآتَيْنَا دَاوُدَ زَبُورًا And we gave David the Psalms, the book of Psalms. And we also believe in the scriptures of Abraham and Moses. Now we believe in all of these revelations from God, all of these scriptures as Muslims, but we hold the position that the only one that is currently available, which we may call scripture in the ultimate sense, is the Quran. Because unfortunately, and by the wisdom of Allah Azza wa Jal, alterations and changes have taken place in the previous scriptures. And I will quote for you some examples. They may be shocking to some, but I ought to do that. Because it is only fair for those who believe that the Bible is the Word of God to get the other side of the story. To get some things which they may have never heard because they are never quoted to them for obvious reasons. Let us just briefly look at some of the textual, biblical texts in the Bible, whether the Old Testament or the New Testament. And I will let the viewer or the listener make the judgment, him or herself. Do you believe that these particular phrases and sentences and paragraphs and words and letters were revealed by God? Because according to the Christians, that the Bible, although it was authored by some other people, it was inspired through the Holy Ghost. The Holy Spirit was behind that. So it is impossible for someone to write something that is, you know, inappropriate or something that is not from the Word of God. Let's look at Proverbs chapter 7, verse 7. It says, And lo, if you don't like to hear this, you may close your ears. A woman meets him, dressed as a harlot. A harlot is a prostitute. A harlot is a prostitute. Weary of heart, she seizes him and kisses him. Come, let us take our fill of love till the morning. Let us delight ourselves with love, for my husband is not at home. He has gone on a long journey. Obviously, if you found this information in a book that your son is reading, you will not allow him to read. You will tell him this book is no good, man. Here is another book about some other stories that don't contain